go to the word of God. Would you please pour on heads and lift your hands up for the King of Glory, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And let's ask him for the food, spiritual food, for his words. Worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Let's ask him for the words what comes from his mouth. They can give us life. They can change us completely. The word of God can make miracles in our lives. Hallelujah. But we cannot change. The word what comes from the mouth of Jehovah God, they can change. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we lift up ourselves to you this morning. And we allow you, Lord, please have your way inside of us. Lead us, guide us, be our coach, our shepherd, our leader, Lord, and our guider. Take charge, take control over us, Lord, over this meeting, Lord, and speak to every one of us, Lord. We need your words. We want to confess this. We will die without your word, Lord. We can't make it without your encouragement, without your words, Lord. Thank you so much. Whenever you speak, Lord, life begins to flow over us, Lord. Thank you so much for eternal life, Lord, what comes through your words. We praise you, we glorify you. If anyone is going through storm, bad season, Lord, tough time, any disease or any depression or anything, Lord, we give that storm in your hands. Holy Spirit, send your peace, intangible peace, Lord. Send your anointing in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, what no one can measure, Lord. Send your love, Lord, and surround us. Thank you so much. We praise you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
that's right. Glory to God. Lord, he put a message on my heart, and I want to go to share with you about this. It's very important, and I love this this message. I love to live this message, and I was trying to prepare something else, and Holy Spirit last week, he laid on my heart, no, don't be rebellious, preach what I am telling you. Amen?
Amen?
So, what Holy Spirit gives us, that is powerful. Amen?
Amen.
That is our actual need. So, we are going to talk about fasting today. Amen?
Amen.
So, fasting, I'm a witness. And some of you also live life of fasting, and you are also witness that whole fasting works. Amen. Bible talks about fasting openly and too much. In the Old Testament, in the New Testament, you can find people of God doing fasting. Whenever the season was bad on their lives and they need help from God, what they did, they proclaimed the fast. Collective fasting, individual fasting, they did that, and after that they saw great miracles taking place. After fasting they saw great response from the God, and breakthroughs came in their lives after fasting. This message is not going to be so long, but please stick with me. We are going to study couple scriptures from Bible. So, what is fasting? It's a biblical rule for spiritual discipline. Amen? By which we stay away from food to develop our spiritual strength. That's what fasting does. It develops our spiritual strength. Amen? One thing is very clear. God is unlimited God. Are you agreed?
Amen.
God is unlimited God.
Yes.
So we are limited minded people. We have little brain. How can we understand unlimited God? So if God is unlimited and we can't understand him, then we need spiritual growth more and more. And the spiritual growth, what we can do, it can be happened through fasting. Amen. Sometimes we pray, and I love praying, and I appreciate prayer warriors. We need this. This time period, world needs intercessors. Amen. But prayer with fasting, it's more powerful. I would encourage you, you don't have to go fast for 24 hours. You can start baby steps. Start with little steps. Maybe you can leave breakfast and you can have other two meals. Then next time you can leave two meals and you can have dinner. And then when you will feel that you are more habited, then you can fast for 1 day. Amen. Slowly and gradually. And we will see the result. Fasting is not a diet. Fasting is also not to lose weight. Fasting is not a starvation. Amen. If we are fasting, it requires that we need to sit in the fields of God. Amen. With the Bible. Fasting meaning simply is this, that cover our mouth from food and open our spiritual mouth for heavenly food. Amen. So how can we eat spiritual food when we are sitting in the feet of our Father with Bible and praying through fasting? Amen. It's not enough just staying hungry and not reading the Bible, or we are too busy with work or this and that. No, when we fast, then we should sit in the feet of God. So we are going to talk in a moment about the purposeful fast, but I want to introduce more fasting a little bit before I go to that passage. The Gospel of Matthew chapter 6 and verse 16, it says, Gospel of Matthew chapter 6 and verse 16, it says, moreover, when you fast, do not be like the hypocrite with a sad countenance. For they disfigure their faces that they may appear to man to be fasting. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward. So Jesus Christ is talking about the Pharisees and Sadducees and the teachers of law. When they fast, they trumpet about that too much around. They go and telling people that, you know, I'm fasting and I can't work hard and you should give me grace because I am in fasting. So I came from that culture, Muslim community. They fast for 30 days in a year. But when it's their fasting, they trumpet about that too much. If you are working with them, I was working in a factory with a Muslim community, so they make me to work for themselves also. I wish they would let me take their salary also, because they always telling me, you know, I'm in fasting, so can you do this for me, can you do that for me, can you do? So it's so hard, it's frustrating when they trumpet about their fasting. Fasting is a personal thing. So they always want you to listen that, and if you will eat front of them, they can make it really horrible. I know they break one person's head for that.
Why?
Yep. It's against over there if you will eat front of them during fasting. All the shops and hotels and restaurants are closed in those days. So we don't need to trumpet about that, because if we will do that, then we will get reward from people, but not from God.
Right.
We don't need reward from people. People's reward is worthless. But reward from Heavenly God, Heavenly Father, it's forever. Amen. We need that reward.
Yes.
Another scripture about fasting, Matthew 17, verse 21. Matthew chapter 17, verse 21. It says, whoever this kind does not go out except by prayer and fasting. Amen. So, Jesus Christ is saying some kinds what we struggle, they cannot go out without prayer and fasting. Maybe we are struggling with the depression which is not going away since months. Maybe you are struggling with a kind of sin which is not letting you go. Maybe there is something horrible which is under the table you are doing and you are trying to run away from that and it's not letting you go. This kind needs prayer and not just prayer. And also it needs fasting. So companion to prayer is a fasting. Amen. What is a companion for prayer? It's a fasting. It's more powerful when we pray with fasting. You can do little steps, as I said. And last scripture, it says, whenever you fast. When means that it's a command for us. It's not an option. It doesn't say if you fast. It says when you fast. So, let's read a very powerful fasting passage we are going to study, and I hope that this is going to, Word of God always touches our hearts. Amen. Amen. Let's open the book of Ezra. Book of Ezra and chapter 8 from verse 21 to 23. Ezra 8, 21 through 23. It's very powerful fast what Ezra did with his people. Amen. So a little bit background. Ezra, he's leading people to bring back to Jerusalem after the captivity of Babylonians. So he's leading them toward Jerusalem. So what he did before he led them? Verse 21 says, then I proclaim a fast there at the river of Ahava. Amen?
Amen.
That's what Ezra is doing. He proclaimed a fast there at the river of Ahava, that we might humble ourselves before our God to seek from Him. So couple purpose of fasting what is the meaning of fasting we will learn in this passage. First thing it says that we might humble ourselves. Amen. Fasting means humbling ourselves in the feet of God. We are relying on God more. We want to humble ourselves and we want to say that God, we need you more. First purpose, that we might humble ourselves before our God to seek Him. Amen. Second is this, they are seeking the face of God through fasting. First, humbling ourselves through fasting. Second, seeking the face of Jehovah God through fasting. It says to seek from Him the right way for us and our little ones and all our possessions. So, first one, humble ourselves. Second is seeking the face of God. Third one, right way for us and for our little ones.
Amen.
You know, we need to know the way from God. If we don't know where we have to go, and we don't have a direction from our God, who is perfect, our leader, our Lord, our shepherd, our God, our creator, we are lost. It's dangerous spot to be. So fasting will help us to know His perfect way where we have to go. So many times when we take decision about something and we don't know what to do, we can fast about that to know His way, perfect way, amen, before we made decision. And we can see in the book of Acts, whenever they anoint someone, whenever they make someone a leader as an elder, they fast for that. Early church did that. So Ezra's fast was to know the way from God for themselves and for their little ones. This generation, we can see that our little ones and this generation is kind of lost. Back years ago, America was different. It was considered to be a Christian country, very powerful country. So, church, we need to fight for our generation, for our little ones, for ourselves, through fasting. We can do that. And we will see the result of that from the Lord. Then it says, and I'm still on 21st verse, second part I'm reading. And our little ones and all our possessions. He's fasting for possession also. For I was ashamed to request of the king an escort of soldiers and horsemen to help us against the enemy on the road, because we had spoken to the king, saying, the hand of our God is upon all those for good who seek Him. But His power and His wrath are against all those who forsake Him. Amen. 23rd verse says, so for fasted and entreated our God for this, and He answered our prayer. Amen. They got answer of their prayer. And we can read next chapters whenever you have time. You don't have to read right now. You can read it at your home. They got a great answer from the Lord. God was with them. So Ezra was facing a great challenge. He had a great crisis. That's why he called people to season of fasting. Amen. What kind of major problems he was facing? He was going to go lead this congregation, Israelites, towards Jerusalem. And between there was so many robbers, thieves, and he was fasting for that. He needs protection from the Lord for himself, for his little ones, and for their possessions. Amen. Fasting means humbling ourselves before God, humbling myself before God. It means I am denying myself, relying on God. And I would encourage all of you, including myself, that we can seek a way, right way, right path from the Lord through fasting. If we want to know the right way from God for our families, for ourselves, for our marriages, for our children, then we can fast. Like Ezra, he proclaimed the fasting. You know, it's a big subject in Bible. We can see in the lots of people, they fast in Old Testament, like Moses fasted, Elijah fasted, and Esther fasted, Daniel fasted, Peter fasted, and Paul fast, Nehemiah fast, John the Baptist fast, Jehoshaphat fast, Jesus fast. Maybe now it's time for us to fast.
Amen.
Amen. We can see all over in the Bible fasting. So Ezra, he became a real hero for his generation when he needs direction from the Lord. When he was scared by thieves, he pray and fast for that. So church, we know who is thief for us. John 10:10. Let's read that. The Gospel of John, chapter 10 and verse 10. It says, the thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. Amen. Our thief is a devil. And this stupid devil doesn't have to ruin over our possessions. Amen. That's why we can fast for our possessions. He wants to steal the peace what God is giving us. He wants to steal the miracles from us. He wants to steal our possessions. He wants to steal our generation. So fasting will help us to secure our possessions, our little ones, our generations, our families, and our everything. Amen. We will see the hedge of protection from the Lord, Almighty God, if we will pray and fast. Fasting will help us to protect spiritual treasures what we have. He cannot steal from us if we will fast. That will help us to grow in the Lord more.
Yeah.
There was a couple more scriptures. You can, if you want to write that down, you don't have to read it right now. Ezra 8, 26th and 27th. That was the reason of fasting, because they have gold with them, silver with them, treasures with them, possessions with them. That's why he proclaimed the fasting. You can read that later, but as I said, that my sermon is not too long, but it's very important. Fasting is not really we can experience through teaching, no. We can experience fasting when we will do it actually. We can see the taste of fasting when actually we will do it. So I will encourage you again, if you can't do it, start with little steps. You can leave one meal, the next day maybe two meals, maybe next week you can leave three meals in a day, and you will see the hand of God over your life. You will see the vision will start coming back on you. You will see the dreams will be fulfilled with the face of God and His glory. I love your dreams, brother. You told me very powerful dreams. Oh God, talk to you about see, you saw that time, yeah, on the prayer day you shared with me. So God, He will involve Himself in our nights and in our days, and we will see new wisdom level if we will fast. Amen. Let's close the eyes and we will pray about it, and we will give ourselves to the Lord for this fasting purpose. Church is the only hope for this lost world. Church is only hope for this lost world. And if we will not take action, this world is going to get destroyed. We can take action, we can pray and fast, and we can save the souls. Hallelujah. Let's pray. And I would encourage everyone, please begin to talk to the Holy Spirit. Worship you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father. Worship you, Lord.
Thank you.
Worship you, God. Holy Spirit, please lay the anointing of prayer and fasting over us, Lord. We want to move more in prayer and fasting. I pray over my all brothers and sisters, Lord. Be with them, Lord. Give us encouragement to do this principle what you introduced us in Bible, Lord. Give us zeal. Help us to be heroes like Ezra, Lord, like Esther, Lord, like Nehemiah, who fasted for their nation, who fasted